Hello, I might shake a little bit in this video. I apologize. Just holding the camera to an internet picture. Was King Solomon a magician? There are people in the occult, I think primarily involved in the left, what is known as the left-hand path, who claim that King Solomon engaged in magic. Now, the data from the Old Testament does not show this to be the case. What we see in the Old Testament is that King Solomon was a very wealthy man, very powerful, and very wise. These were gifts from God. The problem with Solomon, according to the Old Testament, is that he accommodated his pagan wives by not tearing down the high places of idolatry. We see in Deuteronomy 12, verses 2 to 14, I think, God ordering the destruction of idols. So King Solomon was disobedient, but there's no evidence from the Old Testament that he was involved in magic. So I want to encourage occultists, left-hand path people, whatever, to give evidence for their belief. Please direct me to primary source documentation in the BC period, whether in Hebrew, Aramaic, or any language for that matter, supporting your view that King Solomon was a magician. To the best of my knowledge, the idea that he was a magician was espoused by Kabbalists or occultists in the late Middle Ages. But I don't know of any actual evidence going back as far as Solomon supporting this position. Please provide primary source documentation or archaeology or an oral tradition, reference an oral tradition or any kind of evidence. I want to see what you have. There's none because it's not true. And one left-hand path witch on YouTube made the claim that the Bible is a magical book, a grimoire, or grimoire. That is so ridiculous, and it shows her biblical ignorance. I don't know if she's ever read the Bible through from Genesis to Revelation. Read it through and you will see that God categorically condemns witchcraft, magic, divination, things of that nature. One of the most powerful passages, I think, is Deuteronomy 18, verses 9 and following. I have a YouTube video where I quote most, if not all, of the biblical passages against witchcraft. That video is, I think, 44 minutes. And I'll give a link to it below in the description of this video. The Bible is not a magical book. The Bible condemns witchcraft and magic. And the prohibitions against witchcraft were not revoked in the New Testament time. In Galatians 5, the Apostle Paul says, people who practice magical arts will not inherit the kingdom of God. Okay, so the Bible condemns witchcraft and magic. And I'll recommend some reading material below in the description box. And by the way, that same witch said something to the effect that the Bible is a political book. While there is some politics in it, she's overstating her claim when she says that's all it is. No. It's a spiritual book, a record of divine revelation. And by the way, there was no concept of religious propaganda in the Old Testament period. I'm not saying she made that claim, but if anyone makes that claim, they should be aware of the fact this was not a concept. Religious propaganda was not a concept in the world in the BC period. It's a modern thing. So no, there's absolutely no evidence that King Solomon was a magician, that he practiced magic. And I challenge you to give, evidence going back to the time of Solomon. you're not going to be able to because it doesn't exist. It's a fabrication. So I'll put more information below in the description box.